Hi, it's Kendra.
I'm just going to explain this in step-by-step way so that it's easy for everyone, especially those of you who have never painted before and don't know about watercolor. So I'm just going to bring some water into my mixing area, and then I'm just going to tickle my paint. Now, you may have just squeezed your paint right out of the tube, and in that case, it's going to be very easy for you to grab some color, and you're going to have no problems. And you can do this along with me, because I think it's easier to mix paint together than paint together, because you can sort of keep an eye on what I'm doing and do yours at the same time. And I'm just tickling the paint and bring it into my mixing area. Then I'm going to dip in my water, and I'm going to bring my water into my mixing area rather than into my well so that I don't flood my well full of water. And I'm just going to keep tickling the paint and just bringing it into my mixing area. And what you want to do is you want to make a nice big puddle to work from so that we don't run out halfway through the painting. So we're going to be doing quite small paintings today, as you can see by our layout, because I wanted it to be nice and easy for beginners, and I wanted it to be less intimidating. And I also wanted to be able to get as much done as possible. And so it makes it easier when you have small little paintings to work with. So some of you might find that your paint will just shrink up into one little glob. And that is because the palette has no texture on it. And so it's basically hydrophobic and it's repelling the water, which is making it go into a little puddle on top of your palette. So don't worry if that happens to you. One thing that you could do is you could just take your dishwasher cleaner and you could just gently wash your palette, and it will basically make it a little bit rough. And then your paint will have no problems staying put. But I'm going to just tell you right now how wet I want this wash to be, okay? I'm going to explain how much pigment you want in your wash. So if I tip my palette up, I'm just going to put a bunch more water right here to make it too runny. If I tip my palette up, and it's not even too runny yet, but if it all just drips down like this and I didn't have any color left and it was super transparent, then it means I need to add more color to it, okay? Now, on the other hand, if you tip your palette up and it doesn't move at all, then it's too sticky. You have too much paint in it and not enough water. So what we want to go for is we want to go for an in-between. We want it to be nice and juicy. And when I scrape across with my brush, there's still some color underneath there. And so it's really rich in color, but it's not sticky at all. And I've really put my brush back and forth and back and forth until I've made sure that everything is dissolved, because sometimes, especially with old paints, if they've been sitting in your palette, there could be little crumbles that are there and you need to dissolve them in the paint here. So I'm just going to put a little bit more water in this, and I want a nice big puddle, and this is cobalt blue. I'm going to demonstrate the next step, and you can just watch while I demonstrate. So there we go. That's how much pigment I want in my pool. And you can see that I've got quite a bit of paint there. Now, if you're working from pans, you can do the same thing. So you just tickle your pan with your paintbrush and bring it into another mixing area. And if you don't have a mixing area, like I mentioned before, then use a lid or something like that. Okay. I'm going to give my brush a really good swish. Okay, this next part, I'm just going to have you watch. Now, I know that lots of you have painted washes before, but some of you haven't. And so I'm going to start at the very beginning where I first learned in my first workshop of how to paint the paper blue. And so we're going to do a flat wash with cobalt blue. And the first one that we're going to do is going to be wet and wet. So just sit back. I'm going to wet my paper, but I'd rather that you wait, because if you do it at the same time as me, yours might dry while you're trying to watch, and it's hard to paint and watch at the same time. And this won't take very long because it's such a small little rectangle. So what I'm doing is I'm just evenly wetting it the whole entire surface. And the things that I want to point out to you that are important are to make sure that it's evenly wet. So it's not good enough to just go back and forth one time over the area. You want to go back and forth and back and forth and change directions with your brush. Sometimes you'll get little bits of lint or fluff on your paper. Don't worry about that. You can kind of pick them off with your brush a little bit. Now, what you want is for your paper to be nice and shiny. I don't know if I can get you to see that in the camera or not. There, you can kind of see how it's glossy. That is perfect. You want to hold your paper up to the light to make sure that you haven't missed any spots. So you don't have to do this yet. I'm just showing you. Okay, so I've got it nice and glossy and it's not drippy. If you tip your paper up and water starts to drip off, then it's too wet, okay? So then you want to take a piece of paper towel and you just want to soak up the extra along the edge so that it's, or just tap it off so that it's not pooling up on your paper at all. Now I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to fully immerse it in my pigment. You can keep watching. I'm going to give you time to do this. So I fully immerse my brush in the paint so that I've got lots of paint on my brush. And then I can just take off the extra little drips. Like I don't want a big dollop on the end. So I just take off the little drips. And I'm going to start from one side and I'm going to work from the top and I'm going to just go across. And then I'm just going to overlap and I'm going to dip back in the pigment so that I get lots of paint. And this is just making a nice light wash. And once in a while, it's okay to go over an area like this. But what I don't want to do is keep going back into the area that I already painted. So you can see I'm sort of working from one side to the other. I'll dip back in my paint one more time. Take off that extra, those extra drips. I can even use my towel to take off that extra drip. And then I'm going to overlap my last brush stroke and go across. And now this might not be perfectly flat. I have a lighter area up here. That's okay. That's sort of the magic of watercolor, is sometimes you have to let it do its own thing. And one more thing before you go ahead is we don't want to leave any water pooling around the edges because it will go back into the work and it will cause blossoms. So at the end, I've got this paint. You can see it on my masking tape. And I'm just going to go around the edge, and you can even tilt your painting and it will wick up any extra water. If you have any paint pooling on your surface, then you can easily wick it up with your paper towel. Okay, so you can go ahead and start your flat wash. I'm going to work along with you. I have another paper set up, so I'll work along with you. This one here so you can see. Okay, so just clean your brush really well. And then you're going to wet your paper. Make sure you wet it back and forth every which way. And hold it up to the light to make sure you haven't missed any spots. Now, some of your washes might turn out darker than mine and some might turn out lighter. That's totally fine. Because we're just practicing here. We're just learning the very basic techniques and nobody's is going to be exactly the same. If when we're in the classroom together and we walk around and look at everyone's, everybody's painting is going to be a bit different. There's going to be no two that are exactly the same. So I'm just fully immersing my brush in the paint. And then I'm going to start at the top and work my way down, overlapping and every so often getting some more pigment. And then when you're done, you use your paper towel to just go along the edge. And you might notice that it's a little bit darker on the side that you're finishing on. If you're right-handed like myself, then you might notice there's a bit more pigment on the right-hand side. And that's where I would tip it up and just wick off any extra water that's there, any extra paint. And that is because whenever we let go of our brush, that is where the color bursts out from. And I'll show you a bit more about that in a little while. There we go. Great. Super. Okay. So this is a wet and wet flat wash, wet because we're doing it on wet paper. So whenever you wet your paper first, that is wet and wet. And we use that to create a smooth, continuous wash. And the water and paint just bleed into each other and flow. So it creates a really nice smooth finish. Now, if yours is not smooth, don't worry. That's just the first one that we did. So we can practice lots. And one of the things that might plague somebody is to not use enough water or to use too much water. So we're going to get used to that, how much water to use on our paper.